I believe that relationship-based care is something that we did prior to us calling it that and adopting that. But now it's kind of made some people more aware of what is entailed in relationship-based care. As a group, we look at the patient and the individual, and that's all interdisciplinaries of the hospital, whether it be physical therapy, social work, the doctors, the nurses, the aides, and even down to the PCAs.
All right, so we're going to head out there.
And it looks at everything, their age, their mobility, and we'll sit down with them at the bedside, and mainly at that point, it's the nurse and the patient and their family, and we'll tell them what their diagnosis is, what the plan of care is, and we'll ask them straight out, is there anything that you can suggest or that you would like to include in your plan of care? Once we have that discussion, we do communicate it through the interdisciplinary care plan. We'll include it in the report that we give to the next shift nurse. We will also go back to the physician and tell them what's important to the patient and the ideas that they have to help better serve them as a patient.
One of the components of the relationship-based care model is really supporting professional growth for all the clinicians in the hospital. So we have done a lot around leadership development. We also have solicited our staff to find out what they need, what kind of classes that they want to have provided to them. So we offer lots of opportunity for people to select what they want to do. Some of the other areas is we encourage certification of our nurses. And on my particular unit, on the medical unit, we didn't have any nurses certified, and now we have four nurses certified in the med-surg certification and one nurse certified in pain management. She's board certified in pain management. So encouraging continual growth of our staff has been, it's been very rewarding for not only for them, but you know, our patients definitely benefit from what they learn.
Relationship-based care has been a practice in radiology or imaging services for quite a while. Now that we've kind of tagged a name to it and people have related to it and kind of realized actually what it is instead of just saying, hey, let's do this, do that. It's kind of something we can use as our backbone to the way we do our and provide our service.
When we saw you in there, the sun will be blocked from the machine itself, so it won't be beating on your eyes, okay?
So it allows us to take our patient responsibilities from the bedside to our leadership meeting, make decisions as a leadership group, use our experiences, our knowledge of what patients needs and wants, share that amongst the group. From there we can make decisions and changes, and then our director allows us the ability to take those changes back to the patient and do it bedside, share it with all the other LMH associates and co-workers. So we're not having to go back and forth when you want to make a change. It's not going from the patient, hold on, I got to check something, going to a director or a manager to make those changes. You're allowed to make those changes at the bedside, so it's immediate. Patients realize that, you know, the person that's taking care of me actually has control of my patient care. It's not they're here under the direct supervision of somebody that, you know, is not present.
I really like the relationship-based care model because the patient is at the center of it. One thing that we as respiratory therapists rely on is to have a really good relationship with our coworkers and not only in our own department but throughout the rest of the hospital, and that's one thing that relationship the RBC model endorses is good strong relationships between the staff and between the patients, because we are all over the place and we need to be tuned in to one another in order to do our job effectively.
What I see is different is that the patients are noticing a difference. You know, because you're getting to know them better and their families, you're sitting down with them, you know, making that plan of care, including them in those decisions. And then because you do know your patients, you're going to laugh with them, you're going to cry with them. They're more apt to remember you and suggest our hospital to other facilities.
Do you have any questions at all?
So patients kind of recognize that as the person that's taking care of me is very responsible and accountable for what they're doing.
When patients come in, they often have concerns. Their concerns are often different than what we think their current concerns are. Our relationship time is shorter, so we have to make the most of those relationships. We had a young girl came in. She wasn't real nervous for surgery, but in talking with the nurse, she said, you know, I usually have a donut for breakfast. And they were just having light conversation, and she went off to surgery. And the nurse, you know, told one of the aides who had a little bit of time, you know, this patient really missed her morning donut. Could you go downstairs and get a donut for her? She really likes pink sprinkled donuts. And you know what? She went and told the recovery nurse, the aide's going to bring up a pink sprinkled donut for her. You know, when she wakes up and she's ready for that, could you have that donut for her? Well, she happened to be my patient, and when she woke up from surgery and she was ready for it, I said, you know what? I have a pink sprinkled donut for you. She was so excited to have that pink sprinkled donut. It was the best thing in the world. And it's little things like that that we can do for our patients. You know what? She's not going to remember much about her surgery, but she's going to remember that nurse listened and took the time out to get her a pink sprinkled donut. And she's going to tell all her friends that the nurses took time and listened to her.
Well, and the people here really care. I mean, there's a very caring, part to this hospital and to the people in it. I mean, even when you walk down the hallway, people smile. Like, it's, you know, and you don't get that in other hospitals. There's a strong sense of caring and teamwork, you know, that we have here. And I think a lot of that's due to the RBC model.